I've known you for like 10 years, maybe. Mm-hmm. She's my husband's niece, so therefore my niece as well.
I mean, I always knew that she did theater, mm-hmm. and I always thought it would be like super exciting to be able to work with like my aunt. I thought this opportunity is amazing. It makes it that much more exciting for me.
Yeah, and we get to hang out together, you know? We're family that lives on the opposite coast, so we see each other, you know, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and stuff.
And we're so similar.
I know, it's weird.
We're just discovering all these things. We're like, yes.
Like we're both wearing the same shoes right now.
Yes.
Because of her family life and everything that's going on, she's built this wall and doesn't let anybody in. And she has just, you know, discovered that life is easier and more controllable if she just works on her own.
I think what defines her the most, and that's part of the struggle, is her diagnosis, is her mental illness. And what Di's doing through this whole show is trying to find herself outside of that diagnosis, that she's more than being bipolar. So she's also a mom and a wife, and just really trying hard to keep all of that together and to maintain her status quo, but while also being able to fully live and experience her own life. It's very strained. It's a very strained relationship. Diana is very much wrapped up in her own world, and she's very focused on her son. Her son is her kind of prize, you know, perfect child. And so, you know, it's hard for me to admit this as a mother, but Diana does neglect her younger daughter in favor of her son. I mean, she still loves Natalie. It's just not as apparent between the mm-hmm. two of them. That's a big through line of the show, is there.
Absolutely.
Diana's admittance that she is favoring one child over the other.
The way Natalie views it is that she doesn't really have a mom. Like, there is a woman and there's a man that is mom and dad, but she doesn't really have a mom. The journey of finding the acceptance of, like, this is how my life is, this is how my mom is, and I just have to accept that and find a way to create a relationship that, you know, isn't normal, but it's next to normal. Music is something very important in both Natalie and Henry's life. And Natalie is very much the classical music. It's rigid, she's structured, there's perimeters, you just play what's there and you're firm and you're good. But then Henry is jazz music. He's the freedom, he's loosey-goosey, like just go with the flow. And I think that he brings that out of Natalie. He shows her that you can still get to where you want to get and do all the things you want to do, but you don't have to have this wall. You don't have to be so rigid and structured. You can have that freedom. So I think he brings the peace and freedom into her life. Come
see
next
to
Normal!